Edgar M. Queeny, former chairman of Monsanto and son of the company founder, had a lifelong interest in photography. This avocation, coupled with a deep regard for nature and the great outdoors, resulted in the production of a number of nationally acclaimed films. Mr. Queeny was involved in every aspect of the production of these films, including conception and shooting. During his lifetime, they were made available for free showings by organizations across the country. Through the assistance of Jim Rebbe, who worked on the original productions, several of the original 16mm film masters have been converted to videotape. We have produced a limited number of cassettes for the use of valued Monsanto customers and friends. We in Monsanto Polymer Products Company sincerely hope you enjoy the following presentation.
This is Arkansas's Grand Prairie. Myriads of wildfowl winter in its flooded timber. Here one sees all the graceful workings of their pinions in nature's own decor. Here, some of these creatures die, their end hurried by the acts of man. But to this place comes a friend of these birds, a friend who shepherds the crippled and thereby saves others from the gun. Such a friend of the birds is a dog, Mike, a Labrador retriever. Into this exhibition of prolific nature intrudes man the hunter. Paddling the canoe are Jess and Carl, experts in the art of calling ducks. And Mike, companion of man, conservator of birds. They will hunt this morning. First, they must keep an appointment with two friends. All will hunt together. The decoys are out. They are calling. See them? See them over Jess's shoulder? Mike is wise to their ways. He watches with patience, becoming a veteran.
Ha ha ha! There, I got that. Who shot that here?
I didn't. That bunch sure was nice.
It was not always so simple. The hunters had to learn to call, to lead their birds, when to shoot. Mike had to learn his part also. 5 years earlier, Mike opened his eyes for the first time, one of a merry little family. Meanwhile, in Canada's prairie provinces, nature's timeless rhythms brought other life into the world. And as the fledglings grew, they learned the first principle of survival, vigilance. Mike had to learn, too. Cotton Pershaw, a great and patient teacher, taught him obedience, the fundamental training of all gun dogs. Mike learned to stay put until Cotton signaled him to move. He had to learn to hold the bundle gently, because in time he would hold a bird. His teeth must not break its skin.
Good boy.
Then Mike had to learn to take directions against the day when a bird would fall beyond his witness and he would be directed to where it fell. Now, one to the left. Unexpectedly, one day, he held a live duck in his jaws. Ugh, what a strange taste. But it was part of his education, the education of Mike.
Hold it, Mike. Hold it. Good boy. Good boy, Mike.
Next, there was water work. Mike had learned obedience, to take directions, to retrieve to Schoolmaster Cotton. Well done, Mike.
Shed.
And months later, before the hunting season started, Mike took his place with Cotton's veterans, a graduate magna cum laude. Mike was duckworthy.
Mike! Nip.
Well done, cotton. Now it is fall. Ducklings have matured, and obeying age-old instincts, millions convene on lakes of the frosting north. Annually, one wave follows another in one of nature's most mysterious phenomena, migration. And everywhere along their journey, man awaits their passage to claim his annual harvest. Poling out to blinds in Minnesota. Decoys are out on the North Platte. The gunner is waiting. Emptying barrel blinds in Iowa and Illinois. Pitching out decoys in Missouri. Walking through rice fields to their shooting grounds in Arkansas. Jess and Carl again. And Mike. Mike is out for his first hunt. Hide the canoe and hunt standing in the water, Arkansas fashion. And from another rice field, still more birds rise on the sun's first rays. These early arrivals in the flats will soon have much company as others come in from feeding. It is shooting time. They call.
Well, it's been a long time since any Danny comes in.
Thank you.
makes waves to move the decoys, an added lure to birds overhead. Quite in range.
Dad gum. Look down over there. You want to get a mic?
To the best of gunners, and they frightened the nearby rats. But they soon settle in other parts of the flat, away from guns.
Good boy. That's a good boy, Mike.
Mike has retrieved his first wild duck. He isn't too happy about Jess's treatment of it. Chin up, Mike. There'll be more.
That's a good duck there, Jess. Don't shoot him.
There's a bagpack, Mike. Look at it.
Quite right, Carl. Save your shells for bigger game. Rice-fed mallards.
I didn't think that's what I was saying. Thank you.
Two down, one dead, one crippled, too far away to shoot.
Quit, Mike, quit, quit.
From his water level viewpoint, Mike can't see as far as Carl. Now comes a true test of his training in taking directions.
Come back, Mike. Back. Come back, boy. Come back, Mike.
Bring him on. Bring him on, Mike.
That's a good boy. That's good. Come on.
Good boy, Mike.
At this rate, they'll soon have their limit. Not only do birds of a feather flock together here, but birds of many feathers, many species, dance together in a wondrous display of grace and balance.
Thank you.
dance has ended, they leave. But in other places and in other times, they shall dance again. And now, in morning's full brightness, much is visible which earlier had been shrouded by the gray shadows of dawn. The hunting season's first frosts have been painting the land. Procession, this natural pageant passes in a silence emphasized by gentle paddles and the death-still water babbling against the canoe's flanks. A great day for all, especially Mike. There can be a first time, only once, and Mike was pleased with what he saw and what he had done his first time. Mike had learned well, and his ancient instincts tell him there will be another time, another day for Mike, companion of man, conservator of birds. More wings will beat in years to come because of Mike.